Bowmore 23-year-old port cask matured. Is it worth the money? Stay tuned for the Whiskey Whistle. Hey, my whiskey people. Mark here from Whiskey Whistle on YouTube, sharing a little whiskey awesomeness from Winnipeg, the center of North America, bringing you Bowmore 23-year port matured. Oh my God. Port cask matured Bowmore 1989. This is non-chill filtered, and that's a special release, and you can still find this around. I believe it's still available in Manitoba. It might be sold out already here, but you can still find that if you look hard. So this one was distilled in 1989, and it was bottled in 2013. So this one was made when I was still a minor, but of course it was bottled. This was well after my first child was born. I think I was, how old was I? I was 38 when this bottle was made. All right. So we'll get that poured. Now this was a feature of our gala, which was last winter. For the Winnipeg Whiskey Club. So make sure you check out the Winnipeg Whiskey Club, okay? Okay, we'll get that poured. Whoops. Just a nice little amount. Beautiful color. Now, there may be some color added there. Probably not, given that it's port matured. And also given that this is a very special release. Beautiful. Okay, let's look at that color first of all. Absolute rich, rich copper hue. And you can see the copper still behind me and that they are roughly about the same hue. In fact, that might even be a bit darker. Now, typically with port matured whiskies, I find a slight pinkish hue. However, this doesn't have that. It's just a very, very dark color, and that could simply be the age. Yeah, no pinkiness to it at all. But a beautiful hue. So it's unchill filtered, so I'll expect something magical here with the legs. Let's check that out. And I should say a big shout out, of course, to the club, the Winnipeg Whiskey Club. Hello, club members. And also, I should give a big shout out to Jennifer Lee, who handles all things Beam Suntory, of which this is one here in Manitoba. Hi, Jennifer. I have something special for you. Hopefully, I'll see you soon. All right. Let's check out those legs. Beefy first legs, very thick. However, they're very fast. The secondary legs are a little bit slower and yet again, very beefy. I feel like they're beefy because of that port cask maturation. And again, this is not a finish. Look at these third legs coming down here now. This is not a finish. This is full port cask maturation for 23 years. Beautiful legs. Okay, so hopefully we will get something a little bit mouth coating here with this whiskey. Okay, on to the nose. It's fresh. It's got a little bit of peat. But the peat has aged so long, it's changed and it's become fruitier. Very much like the way hops can present as very fruity in beer. Very fruity, very lightly peaty. Lightly, I should say medium. For an Islay, a peated Islay whiskey, it's a little bit on the light side. For all of Scotland, this is heavily peated. We have some burning pine. We have a little bit of Bark burning. And there's a little bit of a roasted ham note here, along with those Korean roasted sweet potatoes, the kun koguma, which is very beautiful here. We have a nice bright red fruity sweetness coming through as well on the nose, which is kind of like strawberry dipped in balsamic, if that makes sense. Beautiful. All right, on to the palate. Cheers, folks. The peat builds in the palate. Again, that's a very fruity peat, if that makes sense. Lots of delicious red fruits on the palate, carrying through all the way to the finish. Strawberry and sweet raspberry jam. Now, if you're not a peat lover, but you dabble in a little bit of peat like Ben Romach or some of the Ardmore releases, I would recommend giving older Bowmore a try, as well as Bowmore the Tempest, which has been eluding me. I have tried to get that here in Manitoba. We continually have that listed on stock as being out of stock. So why is it still there? Tried lots of that in Korea and loved it. Still waiting on a bottle of Tempest to grace my whiskey desk. We have Spanish jamón, whatever it's called, that aged ham that they get there. Very, very delicious, and a little bit of cantaloupe melon as well. Then even on the palate, we get this delicious balsamic vinegared strawberry. And little wisps of smoke everywhere. Well, let's get in some water here. Delicious long oak dominant sweet syrupy finish. I think we're gonna need a little bit more than that. And again, that's 50.8%, so we can add a little bit of water to see what happens. So it's non-chill filtered or unchill filtered. I don't know if are those synonymous? Unchill filtered. Non-chill filtered. I feel like they are. Still clear as a bell there. I'm getting cedar wood. More of those roasted sweet potatoes. We still have the burning pine wood. But it's much sweeter on the nose here. the palate. Cheers again. Brighter sweetness, but at the same time, peatier. Interesting. Smoke wafty, burnt oaky. Kind of burnt orange. Kind of a finish here. And I want to add one more little bit of water. And it's still clear. So maybe there is a distinction between non-chill filtered and unchill filtered. Again, bigger cedar bump here on the nose. Some pink licorice all sorts coming through the pink sandwich. Much more aggressive on the finish. Much peatier. The peat is really building here with water, which is a little bit unusual. But I guess the port cask must really have done a big number on the whiskey, presenting as its primary smells and tastes after all that maturation of 23 years. But you add water and you're getting a little bit more of the typical Bowmore distillery character coming through with water added. It's drier. More burning wood, more peat. The finish is bitier. And I think that this whiskey is better at natural strength of 50.8% than with water overall. Well, in that case, folks, it's time to get on to the Whiskey Whistle Whiskey Score for Bowmore. 23-year-old Port Cask Matured 1989. What is that going to be, folks? It's going to be 88 out of 100. You heard it. 88 out of 100 is the Whiskey Whistle Whiskey Score for Bowmore Port Matured 1989, 23 years of age. 50.8% and non-chill filtered. It's a very, very nice Bowmore. It's probably a little bit expensive if I think about how it tastes and how it smells. However, it is certainly a luxury to try older Bowmore, especially at 50.8%, and also being port cask matured, which presented those lovely balsamic vinaigrette type of strawberries that I loved throughout this whiskey. So delicious. It did kind of fall apart on the palate with water added. The nose was very consistent and different and interesting with water or without. But I really feel like neat is the way to drink this Bowmore. All right. So hope you enjoyed that. Make sure you hit the little link right over here to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell, ding, ding. That way you'll be notified of the future Whiskey Whistles. And if you're enjoying what Whiskey Whistle is bringing to you, then jump in and support me on Patreon and join the Whiskey Whistle crew. Patreon.com/Whiskey Whistle. You can do $1 a month or you can do $7 per episode. Whatever floats your boat, okay? And hey, join the Winnipeg Whiskey Club if you're in Winnipeg, okay? Take care, folks. Goodbye now.